think it's a really good question. Why do Christians struggle with low self-esteem? And I don't know how you would answer that question, what you think the reason is, but I know that there was a time when I was sitting on my couch after doing 17 years of professional therapy and being a pastor, and I was frustrated because people weren't getting, they would get stuck, and they would go so far, and they genuinely wanted help, but they would get stuck in their progress. And I was kind of frustrated, and I was sitting on my couch just thinking why, and I heard two words, identity abuse. And you, some of you are going, yes, we've heard you talk about this, because that's all I talk about, because I know that the enemy uses, he abuses your identity. And a lot of people will say, oh, it's me. If I just thought better, if I just read my Bible more, if I was a better Christian, if I didn't have bad thoughts, if I had better behavior, and they'll beat themselves up. And they don't realize that the enemy speaks lies constantly to you. And then you'll grab a hold of those and you'll agree with them. I tell people, don't collude with the enemy when the enemy's telling you, oh, you're this, you're that, you're this, you're that. And the challenge though is to be able to say, where did those thoughts come from? The interesting thing, and the reason why I'm doing this is because if you have low self-esteem and you've known me at all for any reason, I have not been doing my job well, okay? And so I feel like I need to do a better job of really clarifying what is identity abuse, why do people, especially Christians, suffer with low self-esteem, and how to overcome that. And so the reason why your therapist can't help you is because if you ask your therapist, what is identity abuse? They're going to have no clue what you're talking about. And people say, yeah, I've never heard about that. It's like, because God told me, and my job is to tell you, and I'm doing everything I can to tell you. So the reality is that somewhere in your past, you have received a message from somebody. They might've wrapped it up in a little box, or might've been really ugly and messy, and said, here, you need to believe this about yourself. And as kids, even young adults, or if we've been traumatized, we'll receive that message and we'll hang on to it, and it feels true. So if somebody says, you know, you're inadequate, or you're stupid, or you're dumb, or you're never going to amount to anything, and they tell it to you over and over and over again, it starts to feel true. And you'll ask, and a lot of times we'll just receive that information and just assume that it's true and never even realize that we're believing it. And so I tell the story, and many of you heard me tell that story about seeing my dad sitting on the couch behind the newspaper and my mom confronting me about him molesting me and how he just denied it. And I tell people it wasn't the molestation that had the bad impact. It was the lie of him saying, I don't know what she's talking about. In that moment, when I had the guts to actually say something, and she's looking down at me going, your brother's telling me, da, 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 da. And he's like, doesn't even look up from the newspaper. And it's like, I don't know what she's talking about. And I'm standing there as this little kid, and I'm receiving this information that my value and my standing up for myself is not, it doesn't matter. And that, you know, I just need to be whatever anybody else tells me, because I'm what I think doesn't matter. I received that message before I was old enough to know that I was receiving it. So what I ask people all the time, what's the worst thing you think about yourself? What is the worst mantra that you tell yourself? And that gets repeated over and over again, and put specific words to that. I mean, I actually, you know, if you need to write it out, you know, what specific words to that, then stop and think, when is the first time you recall thinking this about yourself? Consciously, like an event, you know, a specific event. And people say, well, there were so many. It's like, but I want you to come up with a specific event when you were the youngest you can, when you first believed that about yourself, and say, okay, who gave me that message? Where did that message come from? And the enemy will use emotion every single time to get you to believe the lie, because that negative message was not from God. And so if you can say, I am no longer going to collude with the enemy, I'm not going to believe this person, this situation, this whatever, you know, that I received as a child or received during trauma, I'm not going to believe that anymore. I'm going to believe what is true. I'm going to choose to believe what is true. That's when you can start conquering your identity abuse, because your identity is being abused. And people, I've had a conversation with somebody, and hopefully I'm going to be able to be on a podcast soon, just really talking about identity and people who've been damaged by the church, wounded by the church, hurt by the church, and to be able to say, okay, the church is not God. And just because the church has given you this impression, said these things, people in the church have done these things to you, does not mean that God colludes with them and agrees with them. Absolutely not. And so my goal is to help people be freed from these things absolutely every single day. That's all I do. This is my hope and desire, is to help Christians across the planet. Well, anybody really. I mean, I do a lot of work with non-Christians, but my passion is to really help Christians do that. They're hard to help because they're so sure that God's mad at them or disappointed in them. And so my hope is to help people really understand old messages are being repeated in your mind by the enemy. So please don't believe him. And I have all of my stuff, and I don't think I've ever done a really good job promoting this, but I have all of, I have my coaching program, and a couple of challenges like a speaking skills training, crush self-doubt challenge, which is just, all these videos and hours of information just packed that you can just watch online at home. And you can go to fishing4truth.thinkific, which is thinkific, thinkific.com. So fishingfortruth.thinkific.com. And you can find out, I believe there's at least three different programs there. If you want to just know more, I kind of want to browse through stuff, you can go to my website, which is just fishingfortruth.com, fishingfortruth.com. Easy to find. And if you have any questions, feel free to email me. You can just go to identityabuse@gmail.com. identityabuse@gmail.com. All right, you guys, check in with me and let me know how it's going. All right. Talk to you later. Bye.